Hello everyone. Welcome to the 20th video of the Adobe After Effects tutorial from beginner to advanced. If you want to learn the After Effects software completely, please subscribe to my channel. In this video, I will teach you how to use the pen tool in After Effects. The pen tool is used in the following cases: drawing shapes, creating a mask. I select the pen tool from the toolbar section. If I hold the left click on the pen tool, other tools that are a subset of the pen tool will also be revealed. You can also press the letter G on the keyboard to select the pen tool. After selecting the pen tool, the shape of the mouse changes, and like the shape tool that I taught before, we can change the color of the fill and stroke. I increase the amount of stroke a little. Now, by left-clicking on the composition panel, a vertex is created, and after that, a vertex and a line are added with each click. Color is also created between the points. By clicking fill, I disabled the fill color and increased the stroke amount. In this way, I created this shape. Now, holding the left click on the vertices, I change their location. We can also change the location of the vertices with the selection tool. If I double click on the stroke of the shape, a border will be created around the shape. Now we can make the shape smaller or larger by dragging from the corners. If I move the mouse a little away from the vertex, the shape of the mouse changes, and in this case, we can rotate the shape. Because the anchor point is in the center of the shape, the rotation is done from the same point. Now I create another shape. In order for the shape to be created in a new layer, no layer should be selected in the timeline panel. I create the first vertex with left click, and to create the second vertex, I hold the left click and drag. By doing this, the vertex is created in a curved shape. For the fourth vertex, I drag again with left click to create a curved vertex. Now you can see the difference between the vertices of these two shapes. This time, I choose the Convert Vertex tool. By dragging this tool over the vertices, cornered vertices will be turned into curved ones. We can also change the amount and direction of bending by using the levers created on the vertex. If you hold the Alt button at the same time, only one of the levers will move. If I click on the vertex again with the same tool, it turns into a pointed vertex. Now in this layer, I create a closed shape. I adjust the location of its vertices. From the fill section, I choose white color for the shape. Now, by selecting the Add Vertex tool and clicking on the edges, I will add some vertices to the shape. With the selection tool, I change the location of the vertices and in this way, create a new shape. I will add two more vertices and change their location. This time I select the Delete Vertex tool and click on the vertices I want to delete them. If I create a number of vertices and later want to continue it, I must first select its layer and click on one of the vertices. Now I continue the figure by clicking. I select and delete this shape. By opening each layer, we can see the created shapes, and the settings of each shape can be changed. I taught shape settings in previous lessons. For example, now I change the stroke color of this shape. Remember that if you create a shape with the shape tool, you cannot change its vertices in normal mode. But there is a way. I create a shape. To do this, after creating the shape, enter the layer settings and right-click on the rectangle path option, and select the Convert to Bezier path option. Now, by selecting the pen tool and clicking on the vertices, we can change their location and create new shapes. Under the pen tool set, there is another tool called Mask Feather. To be able to work with this tool, I need to create a mask first. So I delete all the layers. I insert a video layer into the timeline and draw a closed shape with the pen tool. Immediately after closing the shape, the mask is created, and we can see only the part of the image that is inside the mask. I'll make it a little bigger and select the mask feather tool. Now I drag on one of the vertices with the left click. In this way the mask feather tool makes the changes. You can see the changes on the edges of the mask. Okay guys, thank you very much for watching this tutorial till the end. Please like the video and leave a comment for me. Subscribe to see more tutorials. I see you next time.